Hello everyone. So you might ask, why is that 65 Oino sideways and why are you holding it like that? Well, this weekend I made a game for the Hackaday Tiny Games challenge. It's under 500 bytes of 6502 assembly code for the 65 Oino platform and takes less than 20 bytes of RAM. It's called Flappy Larus, named after Larus, the main character of the game, a daring seagull soaring through an endless coastal sky. Your goal is to guide Larus as far as possible by flapping through a series of obstacles. It comes complete with print them yourself, over-promising 1980s video game box graphics for inspiration, while the CPU that powered the Atari 2600 is hard at work trying to deliver on that over-promise. It still has a few bugs and displays the score in hex instead of decimal, and you don't get extra points for flying through the clouds, but you do make them disappear permanently, or until the next game starts. Just like the 65 Oino it's running on, it's 100% open source, and if you want to improve it, please go right ahead and send a pull request. Now, I didn't write a single instruction to make the game output sound or music, and right now, nothing is coming out of it. But all along, I had a suspicion I wouldn't need to write much code to make it sound a bit like a seagull fighting to stay alive. Of course, the 65 Oino doesn't have a sound card, it doesn't even have a buzzer, let alone a speaker. But I have a few of these passive buzzer modules with a transistor driver I can hook up to power and some sort of signal. But since I didn't write any code, how would any pin possibly output anything resembling video game sound effects? It turns out the I2C data line has exactly the seagull-sounding square waves we're looking for, and to no one's surprise, it sounds at least as awful as a seagull fighting a cat over a day-old fish. But since the display driver code updates the display the most when something interesting happens, we just happen to get a free sound effect when Larus flaps its wings, when it scores a point, and when it eventually meets its demise, we get a long final screech coinciding with the fact that the screen clears on game over. If you want to play along and don't have a 65 Oino yet, you can either build your own on a breadboard, or use the freely available source to order PCBs, or you can buy a kit from my personal store. The current revision is practically sold out though, so if you order from me, you will probably end up getting an upgrade to the next revision that I suspect will have a built-in serial UART and USB-C instead of the current micro USB. Is Flappy Larus worthy of winning the Hackaday Tiny Games Challenge? I guess only time will tell. Either way, thanks for watching.